Going to get to what's hot and what's not this school year. Stylist Brittany Malone from Diva B Designs is here this morning to give us a look. And you brought in some precious girls this morning to help us out with this.
Yes, I did. They were so nice to come in this morning, early before school starts. So,
well, it'll get them used to getting up early next week. Let's go over what they have on. And we have all different age groups here too, which I think is very helpful.
Yes, we've got two over here that are elementary. They're in fourth grade. We've got Chloe and Kendall. And very retro, 80s is back, you know, the layering. Plaids and graphic tees are huge this year. You've got the little skinny jeans and then the ballet slippers. And then Kendall's here has got, you know, the slouch bag over here, which is great for your books and stuff. Her little kind of bling with the sequins tank top and everything and the skirt and the boots. So both of their looks are easily for mixing and matching with lots and lots of different types of clothes.
Let's move on to the older girls.
Yes, the girls in middle school, we've got definitely glam rock is back. So Brittany here is rocking our 80s, you know, kind of glam rock with the Converse and everything to the jacket with the fur and then the sequins fedora hat. And then we've got the two twins over here, which are so cute because they've got the little skinny jeans, the little small booties, ballet slippers again. Again, all these items, you got the military jacket, backpacks and everything, they're all mix and match.
It is, I think, a big deal for both budget and style to look for things that you can mix and match. But when you're doing this, how do you do it so that it's not too far out there, that it's going to look just right?
Well, I mean, pretty much you're looking for key accessory pieces that you can add that special spark or extra thing to an outfit. You're gonna invest more in your staples, like your jeans, your shoes and things like that. But, you know, spend a little bit less money on some of the accessories that are gonna be more trendy, but that aren't gonna cost you an arm and a leg to mix and match things.
And I have to say that some of this is your very own line, which is really neat too.
Yes,
you've gotta be so proud that they're wearing some of that. Now, if you were going to spend the most money on one item, when we're taking a look at everything that they have on, what are we talking about? I mean, do you really want to spend some money to invest in those boots? Do you want a staple? What should you think about?
Well, I mean, boots are one of those things that you're going to invest the money in and they're going to last you a long, long period of time. So I'm a big proponent of invest the money up front because then you're not going to have to spend more money on the back end. Same thing with jeans. Definitely, you know, there's all the jeans with the bling and all that kind of stuff on them. Invest the money in that because you're not going to have to replace them in 3 months, you know, with some of the other brands you're going to. So, I mean, I remember a pair of shoes I had in high school and they lasted me 3 years, but I spent the money up front and then, you know, they last a long time.
A lot of people are on a very tight budget.
Yes.
Do you have some ideas of places where people can go where they can look very stylish, where it's quality fabrics, but at the same time, they don't have to pay quite so much?
Yeah, I mean, definitely check out your discount retailers. I mean, I got some of the outfits. One came from Kohl's, and most of the outfits that are from the discount retailers, everything's $50 or less. Huge, huge savings there. But go to Ross. You're going to have to look on the racks, but you can pick and choose and find those key pieces that are going to make the outfit for a lot less.
We've been talking all morning here on Fox 26 about tax-free weekend.
Yes.
And you say there are three B's we need to remember when we're out there. What are those?
Well, there's definitely the boots. I mean, you've got all of that. And then you've got your the backpacks, of course, and then the belts and everything. So all of those items are going to mix and match and be able to make your outfits, but from fall all the way to spring.
So just remember that when you are out there shopping, to remember your three B's and you're saving some money on the taxes. They look great.
Thank you.
Still have a whole lot more to talk to us about. What more are we going to go over?
Pretty much shopping tips, especially with tax-free weekend. You're going to sit there and want to know what you're looking for, what you absolutely need that's going to last you through the whole year and take advantage of the tax savings.
All right, looking forward to that. Now, we showed you what's hot, but for moms and dads on a budget, shopping for school clothes can be tough when your teens want all the latest trends, of course. Just ahead, we'll hear more with Brittany about back to school shopping on a budget, how to get the most bang for your buck. Most kids in our area start class on Monday, but before they head back to class, you'll probably be heading to the mall to get them some new outfits for school. But what if your teen is begging for all the latest trends? Is it possible to give them what they want without draining your bank account? Stylist Brittany Malone joins us again to talk back to school shopping on a budget. Thanks for sticking around to talk more about this. We just talked about the three B's that you say are a must for tax-free holidays. I guess that was boots, belts, and backpacks.
Yes.
Let's talk more about some things you really need to think about when you're making that list before you go out shopping this weekend.
Well, I tell parents, if you haven't already done it, if you have a little bit of time before you hit the malls this weekend, go through your kids' closets and pull things out that may still be kind of in style, because again, you've got 80s that are back in style, so you can probably go in your parents', you know, closets and pull fashions back. But mixing and matching, I mean, things are not going to be, you know, to where it's like, oh, that's totally out of style. So use the things that you can, and then things that absolutely have to be replaced that are stained and torn, then those are the things you're absolutely going to need to
do. You were just telling me it's real important to buy hard-working clothes.
Yes.
What do you mean by
that?
Clothes that, again, you're going to invest the money in, but they're going to last the mile.
Yeah.
You know, if you get a good pair of jeans, they're going to last you all year instead of you having to replace them in 2 to 3 months because they're all torn up.
So if you buy a lot of low-quality clothes, they're just not going to last, and your money's not going to really equal out.
That's right.
Now, is there a guide that when someone's going shopping for back-to-school clothes, they need to think about how many of this and how many of that?
Yeah, you've got your undergarments and stuff. You know, pretty much they say anywhere from, you know, 10 pairs of, you know, underwear and stuff like that, 10 to 16 pairs of socks, 3 good staple jeans, things like that, good jackets, 2 pairs of shoes. So literally your list, like, and talk to your kid and find out what they enjoy wearing. You know, if they're not gonna wear a coat, then don't get them that particular coat. Get them things that they're gonna get the mileage out of and appreciate and use.
I think also some parents just say, times are tough right now. Yeah. I cannot afford to go buy back to school clothes. We're going to have to make do with what's in the closet.
Yes.
In that situation, how can they make it look perhaps fresh and new, change up the look a little bit?
You can literally alter things. I mean, if someone knows how to sew, you can add patches to things. Take jeans that may have a rip and tear in them and add patches to them and create some bling on your own very inexpensively. Changing shirts, taking sleeves off. I mean, just things like that where you can alter stuff. Plus, it also gives you an activity to do with your kids.
Sure, and then just mix and match. When we look back here at the young ladies behind us, I mean, if you really just change things up and perhaps don't pair them with something that you paired with last year, it can give it a whole new look.
Yeah, I mean, all of these outfits literally could all be totally changed up and made into all new outfits. That's what's great is the skirts. You know, you definitely want a skirt and top that'll mix and match. The skirts that are here, one's with leggings, one's without, but you can put that skirt with the military jacket or even, you know, something else in the scarves and then create a totally different look.
One thing that you'll see in most department stores, most even discount stores right now, is clearance items on summer things. Well, it's going to be super hot here probably till the end of October 1st or November.
Yes, exactly.
So we can get a good deal and wear those for months to come.
Yes. I, in fact, right now in my store, I don't even really carry winter clothes because it's 108 degrees and who wants to try on a sweater when it's 108? So I still sell dresses up through October, November, because it is so. You can take a dress like the one here that Lindsay's wearing and also put a long sleeve shirt under it, you know, to where it layers, put some leggings with it and boots, and you're good for winter.
Yeah,
so
layers
they mix and match.
Yes. Layers real important. I know you have some really good plans for people who are on a budget. Let's go through some of those ideas so that they can really stick to that budget, stretch those dollars as much as they can.
I mean, again, having a list, that's going to be your biggest thing right now. It's if you're sitting there and you've got items that your child loves to have, make sure you target those items so they get kind of what they're looking for. But don't, if you're going into big retail outlets, make sure you have a list because you're going to sit there and pick up stuff that you just don't need, you know, and you're going to waste money. Get backpacks that are going to last, you know, things like that. Make sure your dollar goes the extra mile.
I know you think it's also important to go through that closet.
Yes.
Get rid of a whole lot of stuff.
Yes.
And sometimes when you see what's left in their closet, it gives you a real good idea of the styles that they like and what works for them, so it makes it easier to go shopping.
Yeah, and also, you know, what they wear and what they don't wear. You can see what kind of clothes they've totally worn out and what items may still have tags on them. You know, so you're making sure you're not doing that, but...
Now, if your child has their favorite store, they always want to go there, doesn't it help to be on all those mailing lists? And I know sometimes we get a whole lot of email, too, but it helps because they send a whole lot of discount and coupons out,
Coupons are huge right now, and everyone's got extra sales going on for tax-free weekend. But, I mean, I know I get Kohl's coupons every week, probably. I mean, so you're going there, and you're going to get the extra incentives, the cash back bucks, things like that. Take advantage of those because anywhere we can save a dollar, it's great.
What don't we want to wear this year? Is anything completely gone out of style that might be a shocker for parents?
Well, I know some people are sad, but I mean, some of the feathers are going out. You know, I know the hair feathers are still there, but the feather earrings, things like that. You've got more of your retro glam coming back in. So it's kind of one of those things, the real trendy stuff, the things like that, it's just not as much. The layering is the biggest thing, the military, all that kind of, I mean, the mix and match is what's in.
Brittany Malone, super helpful. I know parents are saying thank you very much.
My pleasure. I appreciate it. And if you feel free, you can also email me on Facebook, Diva B Designs, and I'd be happy to answer questions on shopping tips.
Excellent information. Clever